Hi, I'm Michael Senoff, founder and CEO of HardToFindSeminars.com. For the last 5 years, I've interviewed the world's best business and marketing minds. Now my challenge is to build the world's largest free resource for online, downloadable audio business interviews. I've learned a lot in the last 5 years, and today I'm going to show you the skills you need to survive. There's 3 ways to grow your business: more customers, the frequency of purchase, and the dollar amount of your purchase. And if you can increase those 3 areas just 10%, just those 3 areas, you'll grow your business 33%. It doesn't take that much effort to make these increases from what you're doing right now. If you increase those 3 areas just 15%, bottom line, 53%, you'll grow your business. Hi, this is Michael Senoff with HardToFindSeminars.com. I know you're going to enjoy this interview. What this is a great example of how to question a prospective client, how to identify and uncover hidden marketing assets. This is a call with Barkis out of Australia. He's a financial planner in Australia. I'm on the phone with him and his wife, and we go over a series of questions in an effort to identify his hidden marketing assets. I think you'll find it quite revealing how a series of nothing but asking questions can reveal so much hidden profit in a business. By the end of the conversation, he was ecstatic, and I hope you'll learn from this recording. Hello, this is Michael.
Hi, Michael. How are you?
I'm very good. How are you doing?
Yeah.
Hello.
How are you doing, Barkis?
Nice to
meet you. Good, nice to talk to you. We've got 45 minutes together. I know Marcia got quite a bit of material from me.
Yeah.
So, teaches you ways to look at your business. The best way for me to help you is to ask you some questions about your business. Would that be all right?
Yeah.
I don't know how much Marcia's told you about what I do. So let me tell you quickly a little bit about what I do here. What I do is I look at a business and I talk to business owners, people like yourself, and I help them maximize their marketing success. Most of our clients are small to medium-sized companies with sales under $5 million a year. I work in a unique marketing approach. I look at all the marketing assets and find ways to leverage and optimize your success from the assets you already have in your business. Now, because I'm trying to leverage existing marketing assets, you can often realize dramatic and profitable growth without having to invest a bunch of money and make a lot of significant changes in the business or what you're doing right now. You know, most businesses are so focused on get new customers, buy advertising, spend money on newspaper ads. It's like we're on a little wheel running round and round just trying to get more customers, more and more and more new customers. Would that make sense to you?
Sure.
It's not our fault. It's just most business people all around the world are programmed that way. So what I'd like to do right now, I'd like to take a look at your business, see where you are, where you're going, how you're going to get there, and see if maybe we could come up with some ideas that will help you grow. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Usually the businesses I talk to are in one of 3 different situations. One, they're okay, but they want to do better. 2, they're stagnant and there's no growth at all right now. Or 3, they're declining. Tell me where you fall into that category now.
Number 1, okay.
You're doing okay. Would you like more growth in your business?
Mm-hmm.
And how much more growth would you like? Have you ever thought about it? Could you quantify it in a percentage per year?
Probably 25 to 30% per year, at least.
And what are you doing right now, like over the last couple of years? How's the growth been?
I set up my accountancy practice about 6 years ago with nothing. My fee levels would be up to about $500,000 at the moment.
That's your gross?
Yeah, that's gross. And I feel like it's growing. Just that I thought, well, let's look at how we can improve on the business and also go out further.
Why should someone do business with you? If someone was to ask you that, how would you answer that?
We offer a very good client service. We keep up to date with all the relevant tax changes that might impact on the client's business. And basically, we also look at the business as the client rather than just their accounting and the tax side of things.
Who are most of your clients? What kind of businesses are you mostly working with?
Small to medium-sized businesses, some individual person who just works for someone who's got a group system, which has got a lot of tax return, the property investors, the businesses which employ 40 or 50 staff.
How many employees do you have?
Currently have 4 employees at the moment.
Do you operate it out of your home?
Yes, proper office, commercial office.
You do have a commercial office?
Yes.
How many years have you been doing this?
I started off in the last 6 or 7 years. The experience that was about 14 years on my part because I had to work for other firms.
So you finally went out on your own?
Yeah, about 6 years ago.
So for 14 years you had experience working for firms as an accountant?
Yes.
Some of the examples you gave me, you keeping up to date, your fees are reasonable, your experience. Do your customers know that when they consider you as being their accountant? Is that something that your customers and your prospects and even your staff know about?
Well, they have our clients. Otherwise, the clients wouldn't come and see us.
Tell me about your current prospects to sales process. Could you give me an idea of your average closing ratio, like a percentage? Is that possible? For every 10 prospects who inquire, how many will become a client? Could you quantify it?
75%.
So 75% of the people who inquire end up being a client.
That's right. We don't advertise, but we have a referral base from clients, so a client will say, look, Joe Blow, and he needs some tax advice, or he was in trouble with tax affairs, or his paperwork's messy, and he needs to see someone right away. And that client would come in, a prospective client. We would sit down with him and for, say, half an hour to an hour, give him a bit of advice and say, look, this is the way we go. And up to 80% of the time, that would be our client.
And that's probably why your closing ratio is so high at 75%, because these are coming in off referrals from existing clients, right?
Right.
Is this the main way you're getting your business right now?
Yeah, we don't advertise.
Let me ask you this. The other 25%, the people who don't come on, what happens to them? What do you do with them? Anything? Any follow-up method or anything like that?
To be honest, my problem is I've been working a lot on the business, and it's made it more difficult to sort of make those follow-ups and say, look, you know, how can we help you? Can we do this? Can we do that? How can we help your business? So it's been sort of maybe slack on my side of things.
That's understandable. We're all guilty of it.
I run a CPA firm. We're sort of fairly similar. We have a GST, which is a consumption tax on goods and services. That was introduced in the 1st of July 2000. It's made accountants much more busier. And there's a lot of clients out there that need servicing. But having said that, you're preoccupied with dealing with the Office of State Revenue, the tax office, and all these other body corporates, which take up a bit of your time.
If you could do 25-30% growth a year, can you handle it? Would you have to put on more employees?
Yeah, definitely. I personally don't do the work. My staff do the work, and I sort of review the work. My time is spent speaking to clients, meetings, phone calls, and what have you.
I got you. How much does each client spend now on an initial transaction? Is there an average you can think about on an initial transaction?
Yeah, you're probably looking at an average around $2,000 to $2,500 a year.
Frequency, is it they come and see you once?
No, they see me probably 4 times a year. Because we've got to lodge, like, a business activity statement return every 3 months. So that's 4 BASs plus a year-end tax, a final tax, with each other at least 4 times. For those who have businesses, those who lodge just an I-return, which is just an individual tax return, do them once a year.
Hi, it's Michael Senoff with HardToFindSeminars.com. Thanks for watching this video. You know, many of my interviews last 30 minutes, 40 minutes, an hour, sometimes even up to 2.5 hours long. They're actual mini seminars, and you've just listened to a short sample of just one of over 117 hours of exciting, hard-hitting, mind-blowing interviews on how to make money in direct mail, advertising, copywriting. I assure you, there is not a resource anywhere on the internet or on the planet that comes close to the free information I provide at hardtofindseminars.com. So go right now to hardtofindseminars.com and you'll have free access to 117 hours of audio interviews with typed word-for-word downloadable transcripts and downloadable MP3 files. Please browse more of the videos or go right directly to hardtofindseminars.com. Thanks for watching.